Hallelujah.
Yes, Jesus.
Thank God for waking me up this morning. Thank God for being here.
All right.
Oh, my God. I just thank God for my wonderful pastor.
Yes.
Deacon. Sister Pastor. My mother, the church.
Yes, Jesus.
And everybody that came on out today. I thank God just over the weekend, and over the week, he just kept me.
Yes.
Thank God. And actually on Friday morning, thank God he kept me.
Yes.
Walking down on my way to work, it was a pit bull out there. Early 3 o'clock in the morning, only thing I'm worried, I'm just tired and just barely making it. And God kept me.
Yes.
A pit bull. It could have just ate me up alive. Mm-hmm. But God was it. Wow.
Thank you, Lord God. Thank
you. You know, I walked, I'm tired as ever walking, and it just came out of nowhere.
Yes.
No idea, but I screamed, and it just went away.
Huh.
And then I'm walking again. My brother was with me, and went to him. And he stood still. He's standing in there saying, oh, you ain't stand still, stand still. No, I gotta get work. You're gonna make me late standing there. So I was still walking, so it came in and I just screamed. And then I'm so, he said, no, he just stand still, no. And then afterwards, the dog, it was a dog on the other side of the gate, like was calling, woof, woof. And it came over to him, I'm running up and down, so I was safe going to work.
Yes.
Thank God.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. All these years, I mean, I started going to work since last year, and I've been saved. Going back and forth to our arms, I hear somebody get robbed, somebody get beat up, somebody, but God carried me straight to work.
Yes.
Safe. And I thank God. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus, because he is worthy to be praised on me.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
No matter how your body feels, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
She is not scared to praise the Lord no matter where she is. Amen? Amen.
Amen.
Like she said, this may not be a full church, but it also says where two or three are gathered in his name, there he will be in the midst. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. Well, I'm going to save the mother of the church for last because she's actually the speaker today. So I'm going to turn this portion of the service over to the shepherd of this house, the head of House of Job, our cameraman, our greeter, our just all around everything. He multitasketh all the time. But our very own Pastor Scott Gale.
Yes. Hey. Yes. God is good anyhow, isn't it?
Yes.
Evangelist, I'm glad you came. I was talking up this morning to Mother Sills on how when you saw the announcement of the service that you asked for more information and you came out, and I know who you are. So it's a great honor that you would just grace us with your presence today. I want to thank you for coming to this place. You don't know how much you blessed me just by being here.
Praise God.
You know, you're just a great woman of God, awesome in so many ways, and I look up to your ministry. It's great, it's marvelous.
Yes.
God is going to bless it mightily.
Thank you.
You're just being here does a lot for us. And I just want to thank you for coming. Amen?
Yes.
And I thank your evangelist friend. You're evangelist also.
Yeah.
Yeah. You could tell you're a woman of God. You just come with the glory of God all over you. And I thank you for your encouraging words.
Yes,
awesome, awesome, awesome. Thank the two of you so much.
Yes.
May God bless you in ways that you have not even thought of yet. May you answer all your secret prayers, prayers that you can't even articulate or shame to even utter. Let him answer them for you right now in the name of Jesus. Let him even go back into time and get those hurts that you even forgot about and make them right now in the name of Jesus. Let them not run around the background of your mind like an old computer program, taking up time and energy. Let them be erased right now in the name of Jesus, that you can be free and clear to do what thus saith the Lord. Bless you that way.
Yeah.
I'm grateful for the members who are not here today. I thought we attract heat. You see, the heat scattered everybody, right?
Yes,
yeah,
talking about the heat.
Yeah, let the cold bring them back. Amen. I thank Mother Sills and Sister Francine. I thank them. They've been with me for years. There's no greater thing than is to have some good women of God up your back.
That's right.
You know, awesome, awesome, awesome. There's a writer who said years ago that if you want something done, you got to ask a woman or a child, because men is always worried about other things, right?
Yes.
We won't go to the doctor. We're big and tough, but sometimes we kind of, you know. But women, because they have that love to even fight a tiger for their children, they have a devotion that is unreal. And I guess that's why God chose Mary.
All right.
And not Joseph. That's right. Let the truth be told. He said what? It would be the seed of the who? The woman.
Woman.
That's right. I'm a feminist and I like it. In the name of Jesus. And of course, Sister Ann. You know, Sister Ann who just came up here, she was a little shy, little girl come up here. I'm shy, Pastor. You gotta help me. Now look at her. She had to bust a hole in the floor up there. God is good. Anyhow, that's why I love him.
He'll
turn those things that you were embarrassed about and turn them into your glory.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
I don't know why it works like that.
Yes, he will do it.
You know? Every time.
Hallelujah.
Every time I preach is my testimony, and my testimony always focuses on what God has done for me during the weekend. What he does to me mainly is that he gives me a word. And every time God gives me a word, it changes my life.
Yes.
I guess I got a lot of issues. Y'all do too, so be laughing.
Amen.
But I found my way out of it to heal myself daily with the word of God and just being near to him. And a lot of things sometimes, we're all ministers, so I can speak in that fashion, okay? Sometimes, as a minister, we're always wondering, do I have it right? Am I doing it right? Because we're still flesh and blood too, you know? And if our thoughts can torment us, because we know what we'll be thinking. The same thing everybody else be thinking. And then we have to deal with the fact that we're called of the Lord. But I looked at Peter, the book of Peter, 2 Peter, the first chapter. And I like Peter. He didn't have the gifts that Paul had. He didn't have the gifts that David had. And he's a man who lived, of course, with the shame of what he had done. Denied Christ 3 times, you know, ran. Started a fight, big braggadocio, or fled. But yet still, God found him to be the rock. And he had practical information. I'm sorry, it is Peter. And when Peter preached, he wasn't a strong preacher. He wasn't a very good preacher. But he knew what he was talking about. Sometimes you don't have to have all the articulate gifts. You just have to be holding on to Jesus' hand. And that's all that Peter did. And Peter gave,
Amen.
Peter gave some very practical advice. It's about being sure of your calling. And he bases this in first having faith. And he speaks about with your faith, you gotta have diligence. And what he meant is that, which is diligence, is that we can't just believe in doctrine. We can't believe we're gonna do it the Methodist way. I'm a Methodist, I do everything according to Methodist ritual, therefore I'm going to heaven. The devil is a liar. You can't be a Pentecostal and say, because I wear this and I don't wear that, and I don't do this, that therefore I'm a holy person. No, you can't believe in doctrine. So our faith cannot be based upon belief in doctrine. You can't be a Seventh-day Adventist and curse out every other Christian who go to church on Sunday. That's not going to get you into heaven. Because the Bible is clear. He speaks about the beam in your own eye.
Yes, Lord.
And the splinter in another. So what you gotta, we gotta base our faith, and what I have to base my faith in is on Christ.
Yes.
And that he died upon the cross. And that I must believe and also confess with my mouth to be saved. That's what it takes to be a Christian. It don't take Presbyterianism. It don't take Seventh-day Adventism. It don't take Pentecostalism. It don't take Methodism. It don't take baptism. It don't take being Jewish. It don't take being Catholic. What does it take? John 3:16. You gotta believe. And that's what it's all about. And he said, in addition to this, that by not having faith in doctrine, you gotta have what's called, you gotta be able to study the scriptures. Now I know we study, I was not a good student in school. I didn't like it. I cut class every day for years. My mother will tell you. I did it. But when you take the time and deal with the Word of God, like I said, it'll fix you. You don't have to be no biblical scholar. Open up that book. Do the best you can. Am I right, Sister Ann? Yeah. Open open the Bible at random if you want, any morning. Amen. And you'll be surprised how he speaks to you right there where you are.
Amen.
There are no accidents. And if you just do that, you will know the contours and the shape and the breadth and the depth of your faith. You'll know what you believe in. You'll know why Christ is so good. You'll see other people who are just as screwed up as you are in the Bible, but did great things, which means you can do it too. In addition to that, we need a little patience in our faith. Patience through affliction. And that's important to us because we get afflicted. And sometimes when the affliction is great, we run away. I know. Put me in a bad situation. I'm not. I don't like pain. Put me, and maybe that's why I'm not a woman, because I would have no kids. I can't stand a headache much. I'm taking all the aspirin I got. And sometimes that's a problem for us. When it hurt, we don't want no more. When God said, don't do this, leave that person alone, no, Jesus, you must be wrong. Jesus, I made a mistake today. I'm not letting go. But if we allow the Holy Spirit to keep us through affliction, it's so good on the other side. It's like going to work with a horrible job that pays well. You hate the job. They hate you too. They don't like you. They don't cuss you out. You had to go to prison to go to that job. But come on Friday, what you gonna get? That big old paycheck. You be smiling from ear to ear. And that's what it is with affliction. If you just get through it. If you just get through it, if we can just hold on and get through our circumstances, if we can just not let go, if we know that we're supposed to be there, if we know it's for our own good, if we can just get through that moment of agony, which it is agony. This is why Christ is great, because he went through agony for us. And even he himself says, Father, if it be your will, take this cup from me. He can take it either. His own flesh rebelled against him. That's how strong our flesh is. But if the devil had his way with Christ, how would we be today? And that's the same thing the devil's doing to us every day. And we say to God, take this cup from me. We pray, take the cup from me. Take this thing from me. But he's not going to do it. And then we get mad with God. I named this church the House of Job because of our people. We are going through. And sometimes we say, take this cup from me. Sometimes we drink, we drive, and we fight. Because it's hard. It's terribly hard. But if we just hold on and see what the Lord will do for us, he's going to get it done. Hold on a little longer.
Yeah.
Hold on 1 hour longer. Hold on 1 minute longer. And he is able to bring you out. Amen? And this is how our faith grows. Just by holding on.
Yeah.
Just by believing in Jesus. Don't believe in doctrine because you worship a certain way that makes you better. No, you hold on. You read your word, and you hold on while you're going through. He also talks about temperance, self-control. I need that. I've been looking at my stomach sometimes. I need self-control. Come on. Who got perfect self-control here? Raise your hand. I dare you. Well, you can raise your hand too high. So I'll talk about you right now. All right. Okay. We clear on that one, right? Self-control. I don't like that one either. To me, that's my affliction. I like what I like, right? Ice cream. Cake. Pork. Chicken. Anything that's sweet. Late at night. Early in the morning. Sometimes I have dessert right after breakfast, huh? That's all right. And sometimes you have it with a diet soda, right?
Yeah.
Like you did. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to talk. Okay. But self-control is important for us because it's another side of affliction. And if we just learn these things, it builds our faith. Like any athlete, because of these great athletes, Usain Bolt, he's not great because he just woke up in the morning and started running around. He's great because self-control. And if we just get the self-control right, we can do a lot of good things. And then he talks about being godliness. And godliness just means being living your life in such a way that you don't have to hide.
That's right.
You know? Because we used to go out during the dark, right?
Yeah.
Come on now. The party starts at 9 o'clock. We show up 1 o'clock in the morning. Right? Okay, but when we live in a life that we don't have to be ashamed of, a lot of good things happen to us. And this is how we grow our faith. And we need this thing. And I know it's a basic lesson, and I'm preaching to ministers right now, but understand, we can never let go of the basics.
Yes, yes.
We can't hold on to doctrine.
Yes.
We cannot. I'm sorry, it's not going to get you through. It's believing in the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the only thing that's going to get you through. And if you do nothing else in life, but you adhere to what Jesus said, not what man said, not what I said. I can only show you, I can only testify as to what God has shown me, just like Moses did.
Yes.
I'm not a Moses, but that's all Moses did too. He did. He transmitted to them what God gave to him. And that's all I can do. And that's all that we can do as ministers. That's it. But we don't want to live in such a way that our preaching helps others and that we are disqualified.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be a mess that if we save the whole world but what, lose our soul?
Right.
And we can.
That's right.
We can do it. People can get saved and be anointed and move on and surpass us.
Yeah.
Because we just won't hold on to Jesus' hand. We have to do that. Amen. Let's get back to basics. John 3:16, Romans 8 and 9. You believe and you confess that Jesus is Lord.
Yeah.
And you get a little self-control there. You read the Bible. And you make sure you listen to what Jesus said. And he speaks to you daily. In your conscience, he tells you when you're wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But we talk ourselves out of it. Just like when the devil told Adam and Eve. Did God really say, you ain't going to die? Hug her tighter. You ain't going to die. You know? Talk to that person no more. You ain't going to die. Put some more ribs in the oven. You ain't gonna die. Whatever it is, come on now. Yeah, it's the little things that get you. Yes, it does, I'm telling you. None of us here need more pork. I got some home waiting for me now. But that's another story, right? That'll pray for my strength. Now, the speaker of the hour is an awesome woman of God, and I saw also her come a long, long way. She was a very shy woman. She didn't want to talk to nothing. When her husband was living, he was my best friend and my mentor. And I used to always push her. You know, she was the first lady. And she played that role of quiet first lady over there, sitting there and smiling at everybody. Right? Then one thing that I used to push her. And now you can barely, look on our YouTube. You can't snatch the mic from her now. God is good that way. He will grow you that way if you're just faithful. And she's our biggest star on YouTube. She, every time I preach, I get like maybe 10 hits. She had like 35. I'm like, what's going on? This thing, right? I'm pulling the plug too. But that's what she does. And I just want to just introduce her to some and also you all know her, so I don't say much about her. But before our mother souls come, I wish you just sit right here so we can move quickly. We have a great woman of God, and she agreed to come out and sing, and also just share what the Lord has done for her also. So we're going to have Evangelist Tracy Shire come and minister to us in song. After that, we're going to have the great woman of God, Mother Seals, also come. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
How many of you know he's a great guy?
Yes,
I mean, for real, he's a great guy.
Yes,
he's the greatest man I know.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Yes.
The greatest spirit I know.
Yes,
yes. It's a lot of spirits, but he is the true and living spirit.
Yes,
hallelujah. And let's just worship him. Let's just give him glory because he's a great God.
Yes,
hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Been blessed this morning already.
Yes.
Already. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He's a great God. He's a great God. The splendor of the King. In majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide, and trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. Everybody. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? For all to sing, how great? How great is our God? You can stand up if you want. Bless him. Oh, age to age he stands. Time is in his hand, beginning and the end, beginning and the end. Oh, God is three in one. He's Father, Father, God and Son, the Lion and the Lamb, Lion and our God. Sing it with me. Sing it with me. How great, yes, is our God. For all to sing, how great. How great is our God. Worthy of the praise. Lamb. Great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah. Lord God, unto me. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord. He is my worship. Oh, anybody love him this morning? Hallelujah. Wanna put a smile on your face? I present my heart to you. I present my life to you. Here's my worship smile. You got a reason to smile. Here's my life, Lord, smile. Here's my worship smile. Here's my life, Lord, smile. Oh, I give you all of me. Here's my worship smile. Here's my life, Lord, smile. Here's my worship smile. Look at your neighbor. Here's my life, Lord, smile. Oh, here's my worship smile. Take all of me, Lord. All for your glory, Jesus. I give you my worship this morning.
Yes. Oh, I lift you up in this house. Oh, I give you glory.
up, Lord, this morning. Hallelujah. Let some fresh drops fall on us. Hallelujah. That we would never be the same. We would never be the same. We would never be the same. In Jesus' name, God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you. Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. Have mercy, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Yes, Lord.
Thank you,
Lord, thank you.
Yes.
Give him all the praise and the honor.
Yes. Yes.
Our Father.
Yes.
Who are in heaven.
Yes. Yes.
Hallowed be thy name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thy kingdom come. Give him all the praise and honor.
Yes, yes, yes.
Before I go into it today, like Pastor Scott say, I'm not a long speaker. I'm not a preacher. I'm just the wife of a preacher. I'm the mother of this house.
Yes, yes.
I'm the mother of 8 children. 23 grand, 2 great grand. 14 brothers and sisters. My mom and dad are wonderful, awesome.
Yes, yes.
They're with the Lord, but we got to go. And I say today, Father Jesus,
yes,
I go to the throne of grace.
Thank you.
Thank you for keeping me. Thank you, Lord, for letting me see my children get this far by faith.
Yes.
Thank you for all things. Thank you for the ride from Jersey to here, safe and sound to the house of Job. I just want to say thank you. When I get up in the morning, I say thank you,
thank
Jesus,
you.
That I got up this morning. I live to see another day.
Yes,
and
yes.
I give my Father all the praise.
Yes.
And I ask him to bless us as we go through the day,
yes,
our service. Bless all the members of the house of Job. Bless everyone sitting here under this word. Under all the praise and the glory. Lord, I ask you to bless us. Pour out your love upon us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Today, I'm going to come to you from Ephesians chapter 6. My message today is, my husband always said, and let me tell you, my husband could talk a lot, and I told my daughter, he's very long-winded. She's saying, you right behind him. The armor of God.
Yes.
Are you dressed for deliverance? That's right. Are you dressed for deliverance? Are you dressed to impress?
Come on. Go ahead now.
That's the difference.
Come on.
Mm-mm.
Dressed for deliverance is the Spirit of God. And the Word of God.
Yeah.
Dressed to impress is Stacy got those stiletto heels and nice dresses and a $400 bag. That's impress. I'm dressed for deliverance.
Go ahead.
Because if that's the case, I had on my high heel shoes this morning. But my old Nita ain't working. You're going to go down and put on flats. And you're going to go give the Word of God.
Right.
My whole thing is today is, when you look at what we're going through today, you got to have on that armor of God. Because if you don't got on that armor of God, they're going to eat you up. And I'm not talking about the armor of God where you put on a big armor suit out of the store and this and that. I'm talking about God, the Word of God. The Spirit, the Word of God. That's your armor. That's your breastplate. The breastplate of God. That's what you got to carry out here in these streets.
Yes.
It's the Word of God.
Yes.
Not your good looks, not your money. You got to have the Word of God on your side.
Yes.
Like it says, verse 10, Fairly, my brother, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might.
Yes.
You got to be strong.
You got to be strong. Whatever you do, you have to be strong. You can't be weak. Because when you walk out there in the street, they're going to eat you up, and they're going to spit out the pieces they don't like. So you got to have God with you. You can't care half-stepping. You got to be there. You got to let them know. And you ain't got to beat them over the head. It's what you do that speaks for itself. People know when you're a child of God. People know when you're doing the work of the Lord. You ain't got to put on a show. Because all you do is just walk out there. And if you got it in your heart, it's going to show on your face. It's going to show on the work that you do for the Lord. It's all going to show. You ain't got to worry. Just like you on your job. Whatever you do, it shows to your boss. You ain't got to go all outrageous. You're gonna, that's a good worker. On time is one thing. At your station is another thing. And being obedient. Everyone in this world has somebody that has rule over them. Amen. I don't care what they say. Everybody has somebody that rules over them. On your job, in your home, somebody got rule over you. Amen. And people don't want to say it, but we do. That's why when I get up, I throw on my armor. You might not like it, but this is my armor. Yeah. God, I'm sorry, this is my armor. Those who prove themselves have true grace. He need to put on a whole armor of God, which he has prepared for Christians. And armor is made to be worn. An armor is also made to be worn and not to be pulled off until the work is done. Until that Christian warfare is done and finished your course, you do not take off the armor of God. It ain't a Sunday armor. Take it off on Monday. You got to keep it on every day. You put it on Sunday morning and you come home, you take it off. No. We're not talking about personal things. We're talking about God. The Spirit of God, how He works in you.
Yes.
You keep that on, because every day of your life, you got to carry that armor to be a child of God. This is what it's all about. That's why I asked them, are you dressed? Because the battle is not against human enemies. We have to do with the enemy who has 1,000 ways to unstabilize your soul, which is the devil. It ain't humans. It's the devil. Because everything they do as a human, the devil has his hand in it.
Yes.
They're not doing it by themselves. The devil has a part of all of this.
That's right.
He's calling the shot. He's taking the number. He punched that clock every day, just like you do.
Yes. Say it.
That's God.
Yes. Lord,
so you have to be like God. You got to stand for it. You got to put your feet on the ground and say, here I am.
Yes.
I'm coming hard. And I got my armor on.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yeah.
That's what you have to do.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
People don't realize it, but let me tell you. He assorts us with things belong to our soul.
Oh, yes.
And you know what that is? Mostly our children, our husbands, our mates, our jobs. He insults us. He throws darts at you all day long. Because he going to get his word over. He's going to get his word across to you. And if you don't like it, turn around. You will find out. We must resolve by the grace. You shouldn't even yield to Satan. Resist him.
Hallelujah.
And he will flee.
Yes. Yes.
All you got to say is Jesus.
Jesus.
Sister Ann said she started hollering. But I bet you inside she was saying, Jesus, get away from me, dog. All you got to do is say Jesus. That resists the devil. The devil flee from you. That's all you have to do. It's call his name.
Yes.
Because you got on that battlefield. You're on that battlefield. You got that God armor, that armor of God on you. Long as you keep that in your heart, that is your armor. You ain't got to go buy an armor suit. You got it. When you open up the Bible and say, thank you, Jesus, I'm your child. Lord Jesus, I'm down here on my knees praying. And you ain't got to go long. Just tell him what you want. And get up and leave it with the Lord.
Uh-huh.
That's all you do.
Yes, Lord.
People got to get this long prayer. You don't need that. If we give away to the devil, he takes the ground. In other words, he planted his feet on the ground because he said, I got you. Because you just gave in to me.
Yes.
Don't give in to that devil.
Right.
Somebody knocking at your door, you know you don't like him. Why are you going to let him in? You see, you driving and you see a person that you know you don't like. You know it's, you know he envy. You know they evil. Why are you going to pick up the devil? Because if you pick him up, he going to drive.
Yes, yes.
That's why you keep on your suit of armor.
Yes.
You keep God in your heart. You gotta let people know, I am his child.
Oh, yes.
We here to sustain the fiery crest of the source of the evil, of the enemies. We have not, and we cannot be religious.
Yes.
Without sincerity.
Mm.
You can't. You cannot be religious without sincerity. Don't let nobody tell you. Can't. Every time you sound 11, you so heartbroken. Sincerely. How are you going to be a religious without sincerity?
Go ahead.
You can't do it. You have to have it in your heart. The righteousness of Christ is imputed to us. A breastplate against the arrows of the divine wrath. Faith is relying to unseen objects. Faith is relying to unseen objects. Receive Christ and reap the benefits of the redeemed. You got to do all this, because if you don't do that, you cannot serve God. You have to be. Faith is a substance of things anyway.
Mm.
That's not what seen.
Go ahead.
Come on.
That's what it is. You can feel God and you can hear him talk, but you ain't seen him.
Yeah.
Did you see him? But you can feel him, because he said, don't do that. He talks to you.
Yes, yes.
Faith, things you cannot see. Objects that you cannot see.
Jesus, working it out.
Yes. That's what it's all about.
Yes.
Deliverance from him is like grace. He is light. It's a shield of defense in every way. The devil is the wicked one. He has a violent temptation. His temper is violent. I mean, we're talking destruction. By which the souls are set on fire of hell. Because the devil shoots darts at you all the time. Darts of fire. He's throwing them at you. He's casting those darts at you because he know if he hits you with a couple of them, you're done. Faith applies the word of God and grace of Christ. That's why you have to do that. Salvation must be our helmet. A good hope of salvation is a scripture of victory. We will purify the soul and keep it from being defined by Satan.
Yes, yes.
Defined by Satan. That's what you have to do. Salvation is your helmet. You have to keep everything with God in your heart, right? Because if you don't, Satan gonna take over.
Mm-hmm.
Satan gonna take over. He gonna do everything he can do, and before you know it, your Christian armor of defense is in a battle. I'm talking a battle, a weapon of attack, but it's enough, because the sword of the Spirit, is which is the word of God, will be there to keep you safe. It's all right, because we need that sword, because the sword is his word. And also, the sword is also the word of God.
Mm.
We need all of that to keep God's work going.
Yes.
I mean, my husband, he was telling me every day, you pray, you must fasten all the parts of your armor. Pray, Livia, but make sure you fasten all the parts of your armor.
That's good.
I said, oh, okay.
Yes.
But I figured it out. There are other duties of religions. And our station in this world is to keep up time of prayer. But he always told me, pray, but fasten all the parts of a Christian armor.
Yes, yes.
Don't go out there loose and just go, out by the by, ain't working. He said you gotta fasten. In other words, you gotta believe. You gotta be sincere. You can't go half-stepping, because half-stepping ain't gonna get you. I learned that too. I told my husband one thing I learned. We must use holiness, although in our course of life, a vain prayer, a vain heart will be vain in prayer.
Yes.
We must pray with all kinds of prayers. In other words, all kinds of prayer. It could be a public prayer, a private prayer, a secret prayer, a social prayer. But with all the parts of prayer, confession of sin, asking for mercy, and thanksgiving, a favor is received.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
That's what it's about. And I tell everybody, we must go. We must do this and be grace. Be graceful that God has kept us this far. Because the Holy Spirit, according to his teaching, not with eyes served for men's pleasure, but as a servant of Christ, doing the will of God from your heart. Not just to look good to a man, but doing the servant of God from your heart.
Yes, yes.
That's what you have to do. Yes. You just can't do anything and call it clean, because it's not going to come out that way. And I tell people, Ephesians says, knowing that whatever good things any man do, the same he shall receive of the Lord, whether he's bond or free. Regardless of what you are, you're going to get the same as everybody else, because he has no respectable person.
Yes.
He treats all us the same.
Yes.
He don't do more for me than he don't do for you.
I'm right here.
Whether we are bond or free. He don't do the same for me, for Pastor Scott. Because what's for Pastor Scott is for Pastor Scott. And what's for me is for me.
Amen.
That's my blessing. And that's his blessing. There's two different things. We need to stop and say, you know what? I don't need what they got. I need what God give me.
Come on here. Yes.
Whether it's a truck with two wheels, God gave it to me. Whether it's a house with one bedroom and no bath, God gave it to me. And what he gave them, a mansion, that's for them. Don't worry about it. Because as long as you got on that breastplate of armor, and the faith,
yes,
and believe in God, the Holy Spirit,
hallelujah,
and God's word, it will take you